What is up, guys? CodeBro29 is back with a brand new video. Today, I am really excited because I'm starting a brand new series. Today, we are starting Roblox Beginner Scripting in 2021. This is something I've been wanting to do for a while, and I'm actually starting to do it, so I'm really excited about that. If you are a beginner at Roblox Studio, or you just want to make a Roblox game, this is exactly where you want to be. I'm telling you, the models in the toolbox, yeah, they can be helpful, but if you really want to make a good Roblox game, this is where you want to be, because you need to know how to script. So, with that said, let's get into the first episode of Roblox Scripting for Beginners in 2021, Printing. So, the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to kind of get you familiar with Roblox Studio. So, it's like Roblox, where you can hit the arrow keys or WASD to move around in the scene, right? You can left-click and drag to look around. If you just scroll on the mouse, it'll move in and out fast. And then there are all these buttons up here at the top. If you notice, there's also a home, model, test, and view, and plugins button all the way up here. Yes, these will be very important later on, but for now we're only going to focus on the home tab. So what is all this stuff in here? So I'm going to try and do my very best to explain it as fast as I can so we can get into the scripting. If you already know how to kind of do the basics in Roblox Studio, you can skip to where we start the scripting. But for those of you who don't, we have a part right here. We can click this button, and there's a part in your game. This will show up in your Roblox game if you published it right now. You can also hit the move tool, move it X and Y and Z because it's three-dimensional. You can also hit Control Z or Command Z if you're on a Mac like I am to undo what you just did. There's the scale button. This is what you use to make your parts bigger. For instance, you could make a door if you wanted. So I'm going to undo that as well by hitting Command Z or Control Z. Then you can rotate the part. All these tools are extremely helpful. Don't worry if your rotate is a little different than mine. I have mine set differently for me, but don't worry about that. Okay, so that's pretty much it for the all these four. The select is just if you want to grab the part and drag it around. Lastly, there's the for right now, there's the color. You probably guessed it. You can change the color of your brick. If you select the color and nothing's happening, that's because you haven't selected your part, okay? So, that's something to make sure you do. Also, some things that we need to have open before we start scripting are, you go into View, make sure that the Explorer is open, have that open, Properties open, and the Output open, okay? All those should be open for scripting. I'm going to get rid of this part because we don't need it anymore. So today we are getting into printing. This is the basics of the scripting, and I will tell you it is actually really helpful for debugging. If you don't know what debugging is, basically debugging is when something is not working in your code and you have to go through it and try and figure out what's happening. Printing is your friend when you are debugging, because you can find out what's happening really easily with printing. Okay, so let's get right into it. So if you have the Explorer open, and over here it doesn't matter where it is, but if you have the Explorer open and hover over this thing that says server script service, this may be confusing, but this is where we're gonna do all of our coding, okay? This is where we will be doing all of the coding for the game. When you make games, this is where most of the coding is. If you're doing like a round-based game, like a piggy game, or maybe not a piggy game, but like if you're making a paintball game, like a lot of this coding is going to be in here. So you see it says server script service. You're probably wondering, how do I get to the coding? Well, Roblox Studio uses things called scripts, as do many other engines. Scripts are what hold the coding in a nice organized way for us. So if we go ahead and hit server script service, click the plus button right here, if you hover over it, then you see all of these different things that we can put in here. Now, this is a lot. I'm telling you, this is a lot to do. But for now, all you got to do is search script, S-C-R-I-P-T. Find the regular script. Don't worry about the local script and module script right now. Those will come in later. And hit script. And now you are in your code. This is your script. Every time you create a new script, it's going to, by default, have a print hello world. So I'm going to go into my base plate and make sure my output is open. And I'm going to hit play. And now, if I look into the output, we have hello world. So the output updated recently, and I'm still not like completely familiar with it, but look, we have hello world. And if we click on it, it's because of the script. It printed in the console. So when we say print, it prints in the console. So let's do a few more things with printing. So we can delete that line and just say print on our own. Every time you print, you need these parentheses because this is basically a function. A function is something that we're telling the computer to do. And here, how about this? If there is a huge difference by printing hello world and printing hello world. There's a huge difference in printing hello world and hello world, and you may be asking, how come? Well, let's play the game and see what happens. This is why we have the output open. So if we play the game, we see hello world and nil nil. And you're probably thinking, okay, what the heck just happened? So, basically, the program knows that we want to print something called a string. A string is anything inside of quotation marks. Anything inside of quotation marks is a string. But if we don't have it in quotation marks, it doesn't know what to do. It thinks it's something called a variable. Now, we'll get more into variables later, but it thought that we had a variable. Roblox, okay? It thought that hello and world were variables. So variables, like I said, we'll get into a different episode. Basically, don't worry about it right now. Just for now, make sure that you only have quotation marks when you're printing. Later on, we will get into printing where we use non-quotation marks with variables, and I believe that'll be actually next episode, so make sure to stay tuned for that because that's a really fun one. That's where we really get some help with debugging. Okay, so something that's really helpful in Roblox Studio, we've gone over printing, is I want to show you guys really quickly a wait, okay? So it's totally okay if you do not understand this. And spacing doesn't matter. It is not sensitive. This Roblox is not sensitive in that way. You can have as many spaces as you want. This will still work and do the exact same thing as if I did just that. It would do the exact same thing. It's up to your style. I like to spread mine out on a couple lines. But when you print hello world, we've already gone over that. That's going to print in the console. Now, make sure that you know that this is not something that the players in your game will see. It's just something for you to help you with your coding and making it easier for you. So the one thing I wanted to point out really quick, or the one other thing I wanted to show you really quick is a wait. So I'm going to go ahead and say print hello world like we already have. I'm going to say wait 3. And print hello world again. So what do you think this is gonna do? You can pause the video and look at it and see if you can figure it out. Well, if you said it's gonna print hello world and then 3 seconds later it's gonna print hello world again, you would be correct. Great job. If you didn't, don't worry about it at all. This is really, it's coding is not easy when you start, but as you get more familiar with it, it gets so much easier as you go. Like right now, it's not that hard anymore because I've been scripting for years. But basically what this is saying is it's gonna print hello world in the console, hello world, then it's going to wait 3 seconds before doing anything that's past line 3 or this line. It's gonna wait 3 seconds and then it'll do everything over here. So if we play the game, you can see that this actually works. If we look in the output, it'll say, hello world, 1, 2, 3, hello world again. So if you see, it said hello world, waited 3 seconds, and said hello world again. So that's how you use printing and waits. One more thing I really want to say before this episode is over, if you click on a script in the Explorer, and if it's closed like this and you don't know where your script is, just hit that little arrow and it'll open up the script. And I want to show you how to rename your script, because it's really frustrating. I've done this before where I haven't named any of my scripts, and I don't even know what scripts I'm doing. I have to check through all of them to find the one I'm looking for. So I'm going to hit the name, and I'm going to call this Hello World Script. This is in Properties, okay, and under Name. Again, there are lots of drop downs, so you can click this little arrow. So I renamed it to Hello World Script. That way we know exactly what script this is if we ever close that and come back in, because it's our Hello World script. So that is pretty much it for this video. Something really quick I want to make sure you guys are aware of, though. If you didn't watch my How to Make a Roblox Game, there'll be a card in the top right corner if you want to view that. Everything that your player is going to see is going to be in this thing called the workspace. As you can see, the workspace has a base plate by default, a terrain, and a camera. If you don't know how to make a new Roblox game and you were stumped the whole time, also check out the how to make a Roblox game in 2021. But I'm assuming you have a basic-ish knowledge of Roblox Studio. Just basically, I'm assuming that you know how to open up a game. So that is pretty much it. So, but what I was trying to say is that if you put a part in like we did earlier, you will notice that the part is in the workspace. It's not in anything else. But if I drag this part into any of these other things, it's not visible anymore. Nobody can see it. No one at all can see the part. So that, like I said, that's pretty much it for this video. If you liked it, please hit that subscribe button. I spent a lot of time on these videos for you guys, and I hope that they're helpful. I really enjoy this series, I am going to really enjoy continuing the series. This is going to be a fun one, so make sure to subscribe, hit that notification bell, because that's how YouTube works, and hit that like button. So, I hope you enjoyed it, and if you did, stay tuned for the next one. Thank you for watching. See you next time.